Have you just got a new poodle puppy? Well, something you definitely need to teach them is their name, and today we're going to teach you how to do that. Welcome back to the Fenrir Poodle Show. My name's Joe and I'm a certified canine leader here at FenrirCanineLeaders.com. We are dedicated to helping you learn everything you could possibly want to know about the poodle and then how to become a high-level canine leader so you can raise your very own. So if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss a future upload. Teaching your poodle their name may seem a simple task, but actually, how do you go about that? Well, today we're going to be tuning into a webinar that the canine behaviorist and founder of FenrirCanineLeaders.com, Will, has recorded all about how to teach your puppy their name.
So welcome back to another quick fire breakdown of a very common question that you will get from new puppy owners, whether you're interested in working as a dog trainer. Even canine behavior work gets this question quite commonly, or even if you're just watching this because you're trying to get yourself to become a high level canine leader and you want to kind of understand more of the theory around this thing. So most people get dead excited about getting their new puppy and they have the name planned out long before the puppy comes home, and they tend to go into the process of teaching their dog name completely naively, if I want to be honest and use maybe a little bit of a harsh term with it. And what we absolutely must start with when it comes to teaching a puppy its name and teaching it its name so that it's an effective tool that as a high level canine leader we can utilize every single day, is we must have an excellent comprehension and an understanding that a dog has no comprehension and understanding that it has a name, nor is there any amount of training. Even the best obedience trainer in the world can't teach a dog to understand the concept of it having a name. What we need to understand is that a name to a dog is nothing more than an additional command. Again, I think one of the reasons so many people struggle with their dogs right now is because of anthropomorphization, which, if you didn't know what that term means, it means basically attributing human-like behaviors or emotions to an animal. Too many people are treating their dogs like children and babies, and they baby them and they utilize their name in that kind of fashion. And we need to remember that when we talk, we have language and communication. Not only are we speaking a foreign language to a dog, at least when you hear someone speaking a foreign language, you get the concept, oh, they're communicating just in a language I don't understand. A dog has zero comprehension that that's even a form or methodology of communication. And what we need to do is assign that, which is basically just noise coming out of our mouths, because they have no comprehension that that is words and that those words represent meaning in any kind of form. But we need to make them understand that this noise that is coming out of them, out of our mouths, that we have assigned as their name, is nothing more than an additional obedience command. So when the owners that you're working with kind of have that light bulb moment, first of all, it's an excellent opportunity to start going down that process of more effective communication with our dogs, and how people can build those better relationships when they understand that if we understand them as dogs and treat them as dogs, that actually that allows us to build the better relationship than if we babied them and treated them like children and babies. So it's a really fun, engaging conversation that you can have with new owners to be able to start them down that path of kind of understanding that thing that's probably more of a macro issue, but we can help them understand the macro theory and issue using this micro issue or thing of teaching a dog its name. So what we then do is we go through explaining, okay, awesome, you understand that concept now, that macro overarching theory that a dog will never know it has a name, and that it's simply assigning this noise that comes out of our mouth to a very basic and simple obedience trick, just how we would teach a dog that the term sit means I want you to pop the behavior of your bum going on the floor is assigned to this word. I've marked this noise coming out of my mouth is assigned with that behavior, and if you do that from me, something good is going to happen. That's obviously a very positive reinforcement based approach to it. When it comes to teaching a dog its name, we want to take a very positive based approach to teaching a dog its name. But if we now know it's nothing more than an obedience kind of trick or command, what do we want it to be? Well, the way that I teach all of the clients and people that I work with is that the dog's name simply means stop what you're doing, look up to me for guidance and direction, because another command is about to come your way that I need you to listen to. So again, when you think ahead of maybe you've had dogs in the past, but when is it that you actually use a dog's name? Well, there's usually one of two things. First of all, you're speaking to another human and you want to let them know that you're referring to this in particular dog. So we might use that dog's name. That's irrelevant to our relationship with the dog and the way that we work with our dog. That's absolutely fine. We remove that from the table. Next thing, it is always some kind of, I'm not going to use my dog's name because he's fast asleep on the sofa there. We've been out working him all morning, but let's use Dave the dog. It'll be some kind of form of Dave, stop. Dave, come here. Dave, sit. Dave, no. Dave, down. It's always some kind of getting their attention, and then I want you to stop doing something, or I want you to do something. So again, it might be Dave, no. Dave, stop. Or it might be Dave, come. Dave, heel. Dave, sit. Dave, stay. So what we want from them is stop what you're doing, break, get their attention up to us. And then ideally, I want you to look up to me for guidance and direction. It's a theory and a principle that I talk about in most training videos. The importance of that relationship, that the dog sees you as its calm, consistent leader. That then my next kind of catchphrase on from that is that we'll look up to you for guidance and direction. That's so incredibly important because we need them to look up to us for guidance and direction so that we can then utilize our obedience. Now, being able to help get that guidance and direction, that looking up, that is what the command of their name should be used, in my opinion. So the way we teach that is a very basic, very simple principle of teaching a dog its name. I recommend that all owners start from the second they bring their dog home working on this. If people are following along with my Perfect Puppy course, then we use this as part of our Fenrir basic obedience kind of training drill. And we do this drill kind of a few times a day, every single day. And the drill will get more complex and more complicated as time goes on and we bring on the more higher levels of obedience. But we always start with teaching the dog its name because we want to get that dog to look up to us for guidance and direction so that we can then layer on top of that all the different other obedience things that we need to work on. So again, it's in that Perfect Puppy course, but a very quick overview of that is we get a little piece of food and we do a very basic lure, mark, reinforce, like you would do for pretty much all obedience work. So we're going to get the dog's attention with the food, following their nose. We bring that food up to our face. We don't want to cover up our eyes because we always want that. It's that eye contact that we're looking for. Naturally, the dog's going to follow the food. As we bring it up to the face, the dog's going to look up because they're following the food. As we get that behavior of them looking up, we mark it with their name. Again, it's nothing more than a command, but with name. So if eyes come up, as the dog follows, Dave. Yes, good. Then they get access to the food. And we drill that and we drill it like you would with teaching sit, like you would with teaching down, like you would with teaching heel. We put the repetitions in. We work and we work and we work. Now, obviously, at these early stages, yes, the dog is following the lure of the food because they're interested in it. So then over time, we're not going to bring it right up to our eyes. We're going to bring it a little bit lower. And that's where a little bit of finesse comes into this, a little bit of patience. Bringing it up, the dog's going to be looking here, so they're going to look up, but not all the way up through our eye contact. We're going to bring it up, we're going to remove all the excitement, and we're going to patiently wait. And I promise you, if you put those drills in right up at the eye contact, you are going to get a little glance from the puppy. They're staring at the food here, they're staring, they get a little bit confused, followed by looking up. And that's the gem moment. When we get that look up into your eyes, we mark it and then we heavily reinforce it with praise, food. Oh, who's a good boy? Yes, Dave, who's a good Dave? Yes, lots of praise. Let them know I love what you just did. Then we repeat that, and again, you'll very quickly get to the point where the dog's looking up. We can then start to mark the behavior just before they do it. We go through that very same principle to a point where you use that terminology, their name. Again, it's nothing more than a command. Because again, you don't have to teach sit. You could teach that with pineapple and you could get a dog to sit with pineapple. It doesn't matter what the word is because a dog has no comprehension of language or words. It's just a noise that comes out of our mouth that we associate with a behavior. So whatever you want to name your dog is irrelevant. It doesn't matter. It can be literally anything in the world as long as we're consistent with it and we do this as part of the training. So again, this is one of those things that it's a small micro piece to the puzzle of dog ownership and canine leadership, but we can utilize it as an excellent teaching method and opportunity to teach the more macro picture of relationship and communication with our dog and get into that higher level level of understanding and being able to treat them like a dog to then be able to build a better relationship with them as a dog. When we do that, dogs aren't filled with anxiety and fear because they trust in you as a calm, consistent leader, which then means they don't spiral into reactive and anxious type behaviors, which is riddling the dog population of the world at the minute. So again, very simple process, but a really excellent opportunity, something that we can be extremely positive and fun about. So get out there, whether you're working with clients or working with your own dog, get out there, have some fun with it, and make the most out of what is quite an easy thing to achieve really quite big results with a micro piece of information.
There you have it, guys, some really useful tips and tricks how to teach your poodle puppy their name. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, get involved in the comments down below as we would love to hear from you. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell as we have two dedicated videos coming out every single week. So I can't wait to see you in the next episode of the Fenrir Poodle Show.